Start the book of Acts. If you like, if you are a good historian, some of you are very well educated and can do this research. So I'm not telling you something esoteric that is not found anywhere. I'm just telling you an historical truth. After the revolution that happened, did you know it's a revolution for people to say, these men that have turned the world upside down have come again. Did you hear what I just said?
Yes.
The fathers of faith, the 12 disciples and their followers, anywhere they get to, they said, these men that have turned the world, it's a revolution to turn the world upside down. This is how we are doing it. No, we will not do it that way, and it will still work. How did they turn the world upside down? Instead of going to Santom, they said, no, we are not going to Santom. That's hybrid. Take me to Braamfontein. The scripture recorded that Peter was going in the quarters of Jerusalem. That is the slum of Jerusalem. That is the Braamfontein of Jerusalem.
Right.
And his shadow. If it's in Santom, listen very well. There's no way you can see the shadow of Peter because he will be in a well-sealed house with big men, cool atmosphere, in the dusty quarters slum of Jerusalem, house to house. They were breaking bread, house to house, daily, daily. They were breaking bread from house to house. So somebody said we can only eat communion one day, once a month. Our fathers of faith, Peter and all of them, and the apostles, from house to house. So if you get to 50 houses in a day, you take communion 50 times.
Yeah.
Don't let any religious denomination tell you that it's only once a month you can take communion. I didn't see that in my own Bible. Help me, Lord. Are they getting it? Don't let any denomination tell you that it's only once a month. Our fathers of faith were breaking bread from house to house, and they were joyful. From house to house. So if they touch 50 houses, in fact, they don't, by the time you hit communion 50 times, you are full. Are you with me? And do you know what that one means? Communion is more bread than and Jesus. It is the food. When you hit the flesh of Jesus 50 times, you drink the blood of Jesus 50 times in a day.
Amen.
Don't you know you have become Jesus? You didn't agree with me. It's not bread they were eating. They were breaking bread. The word breaking means that it's no longer physical bread. It has become the broken body of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And they now took that from house to house. And in a day, they paraded 50 houses. You hate Jesus 50 times. Why won't your shadow heal the sick? Are you getting me?
Yes.
Don't let anybody confuse that you can only eat it once a day. He said, Papa, after we break communion in the morning, I feel like, I said, go ahead, eat it again. They said the communion is once. No, you can break it into 50 times. One, six, two, I'm telling you practicality of Christianity. I'm not telling you religiosity. I'm telling you spirituality. Until you become another man, until you become another woman, you won't get to that another place that none of us have gotten to. There is a place in power. It's called another place. You can't get there until you do the another thing that nobody has done. You saw everybody breaking communion and they eat it once. You now break your own to 50. 50 times, you are already mad. You are going bastard! Why are you laughing? I said do something different.
Amen.
I read it in my Bible. They go from house to house breaking bread. So I interpreted that to me that if they go to 50 houses in a day, they broke bread 50 times.